And now for something completely different. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is my first kind of foray into the BookTube universe. As you may or may not know, I got very hurt in August and I have been down for like 4 months. I broke bones, I sprained things, I had surgery. It's been a whole thing. I've had a lot of free time on the couch, and as a result, I have had so much time to read. I don't really talk about reading and books that much on my channel, and that's something I'm willing to change if you're into this. I am a total Ravenclaw. I've been an avid reader my entire life. I don't know why this is something I never really like share with you guys on my channel, but if you're into it, I would love to continue. Just let me know in the comments. That being said, I have this pile here. Oh yeah. Of books that I read while I was down for the count, and I thought I would just go over and share them with you guys. First things first, I just finished this today, and it's taken me about 100 years to read. This is Outlander by Diana Gabaldon. I'm wearing tartan today in celebration because I finally finished this book. Took me a little bit to get into, I'm not gonna lie, but I wound up loving it. I can't wait to get the next one. I don't watch the show, but I am starting it tonight. I'm sure so many of you are familiar with this, but if you're not, it is a time travel Scottish romance situation with some violence and some magic, and I like it a lot. I'm very excited to see what happens next. Next is A Monster Calls by Patrick Ness. This one I read in like a day. It's definitely an easy read. It's very sad. It is a super sad book. The main character is a boy named Connor whose mom is very sick, like deathly sick. And then one night a monster shows up at his window, kind of winds up being like a manifestation of Connor's feelings. It's real sad. I tried to watch the movie after I read the book, and I just wasn't in the right mood to cry, so I turned it off. If you guys have seen the movie, let me know if you like it. I like the book very much. It just like wasn't a feel-good story necessarily. For a little comic action in here, we've got book one of The Saga of Swamp Thing by Alan Moore. Number one, the artwork in this is amazing. It's so beautiful, and a lot of it has this kind of psychedelic vibe. I'm trying to find. See what I mean? Doesn't this kind of look like a 60s album cover? Alan Moore is one of my very favorite writers. He's legendary. He's responsible for Watchmen, which is just one of my favorite things in the entire world. It's just very smartly written, very strange at times. I mean, obviously, like, Swamp Thing is a swamp monster, essentially, and you kind of find out why he is what he is, which is probably my favorite part of these books. While I am a comic collector, I'm not necessarily collecting things for value. I'm collecting them because I like them and I enjoy reading them. So books like these I actually love because I have all of the comics in this. It's safe. It's got like a cover and a binding, and it's not gonna get messed up. Next is a book I've been meaning to read for a very, very, very long time, and that's Middlesex by Jeffrey Eugenides. My sister actually lent me this to read while I was laid up, and I really enjoyed it. The main character, Calliope, is born with both parts and ultimately decides to become Cal. It's all about the genetic history and background of Cal's family. I don't really know what I was expecting, but this book surprised me because it reads like an epic, and I get why this book is such a giant deal. I think everything else is like very fan to me. Okay, so I also read this. This is not something I've talked about on my channel. I don't know, maybe I should do like a separate video kind of processing, because we did lose Stan Lee not that long ago, and I wasn't vlogging at the time, and I did actually turn the camera on to make a video, and I just couldn't stop crying, and I didn't want to like put that out there. So this is Amazing, Fantastic, Incredible, A Marvelous Memoir by Stan Lee. This is a comic that he wrote just going over his life story, which is amazing, as the title would suggest. I had read this before, but I picked it up for a reread after I found out he had passed away. This book actually has a really cool memory attached with it because it is signed by Colleen Duran. It says, "To Jess, make mine Marvel." She was one of the artists that worked on this book, and the day I picked it up, it was at Wizard World, and I was actually cosplaying Stan Lee, and she took my picture and she texted it to Stan. I mean, what? Not only do I love this because Stan Lee was such like a big personal hero of mine, but also it has such like a special memory attached to it. And I cannot recommend this enough if you are a fan of Marvel, Marvel movies, Marvel comics. What an amazing life story. What an amazing love story he had. It's real good. And I miss him. Here's another book that took me 100 years to read. And this is A Clash of Kings. This is the second book of the Game of Thrones series by George R.R. Martin. I am very slowly trucking through the books. I cannot wait for the final season. And so these are kind of like tiding me over in the meantime. I really don't have much to say on it. I mean, the first book is pretty much exactly season one of Game of Thrones. This one just kind of follows suit. I'm honestly not sure how much the show will deviate from the books. I know the show is ahead of the books. I'm really interested to read on and see what happens in the books compared to how the show ultimately finishes up. Next up is Family Don't End with Blood, edited by Lindsay Bernis. This book is a collection of essays written by fans and cast members of Supernatural. This is all about Supernatural and the fandom. It took me a very long time to get into the Supernatural fandom, not because I didn't want to, but because there's just so much of it out there, and being so late to the party, that's a whole 13 seasons to catch up on. Part of what gave me the kick in the butt to finally start Supernatural is how cool the fandom seemed. And this book is a prime example of that. There are essays from Jared Padalecki, Jensen Eccles, Misha Collins, so many cast members talking about how being on the show has affected them, how the fandom has affected them. Jared Padalecki's essay is especially like, I teared up. It made me cry a little. So lots of essays by fans, lots of people finding themselves in dark places and being pulled out of it by Supernatural, which is really cool. If you're a Supernatural fan and you haven't read this yet, highly, highly, highly recommend. This book is awesome. Finally, and this might be my favorite one out of all of them, is Ship It by Britta London. This is a YA novel, and if you are any kind of fangirl, you are going to really enjoy this. If you go to conventions, you're gonna like this. Claire, the main character, is obsessed with a show called Demon Heart, which reminded me very much of Supernatural. However, the two characters are not brothers, not related in any way. So a lot of fangirls and fanboys of Demon Heart ship the two main characters. Claire goes to the Demon Heart panel and asks one of the lead actors about the fandom shipping those characters, and he laughs it off like it's ridiculous his character could be gay. This kicks off a whole story about figuring out who you are, figuring out your sexuality, accepting yourself, accepting others. It was a really, really fun read. Again, if you are a convention goer, a lot of this will hit very close to home for you. And I have to show you under the jacket because this book is just like visually so cool too. This is what it looks like underneath the jacket. It's everybody cosplaying at the convention. How cool is that? So that is going to do it for my first foray into the BookTube universe. Please let me know in the comments down below if you would like to see more of these kinds of videos. Have a pile of books to be read if you want like a TBR video or maybe like a monthly check-in. I'd totally be willing to do that with you guys. Also, January is Potter month, so really the TBR list will be on hold until I read all of the Harry Potter books. I challenge myself in the month of January to reread all of the books, watch all the movies, just within the confines of the month of January. If I'm feeling like a little extra credit, I will reread Cursed Child. Maybe I'll feel differently about it. Probably not. Maybe a little Fantastic Beasts, Beetle the Bard. I'm getting very much ahead of myself. Potter month is coming, but we will talk about that more later. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit subscribe if you'd like to keep hanging out, and I will see you in another video. Bye.